of colloids based on the interaction between DPA and DM. Based on this category, there are two types of colloids. Based on the interaction between DP and DM, DP means dispersal phase, DM means dispersion medium. In this category, we have two types. What are those two types? First one, lyophilic colloids. Lyophilic colloids. Second one, lyophobic colloids. First one, lyophilic. Second one, lyophobic. What are lyophilic colloids? These are solvent loving colloids. Solvent loving colloids. Solvent loving means, you know, there is strong affinity. Affinity means attraction. Here, strong attraction or affinity between DP and DM, between dispersed phase and dispersion medium, there is a strong affinity. Lyo means solvent, philic means loving, philic means loving, that means attracting. If a solvent is water, if dispersion medium DM is water, then we use the word hydrophilic. If the solvent is water, then we use the word hydrophilic. In place of lyophilic, we use the word hydrophilic. Lyophilic is the common word. That means whatever may be the solvent, we use the word lyophilic. If water is the solvent, then specifically we use the word hydrophilic. So which compounds form this type of lyophilic colloids? Substances with high molecular masses. Substances with high molecular weights form this type of colloidal solution. Substances with high molecular weight form this type of colloidal solution. See examples: starch, gelatin, okay, gum arabic, proteins, etc. Proteins, etc. So these compounds are generally in water. These compounds in water form hydrophilic. Hydrophilic means lyophilic colloids, etc. in water. Okay. So lyophilic colloids means there is strong affinity between dispersed phase and dispersion medium. Affinity means attraction. This is first type. Second one, lyophobic. Lyophobic colloids. So here, these are solvent hating. These are solvent hating. That means they do not attract DP, in between DP and DM, dispersal phase and medium, no affinity or little affinity. So no or little affinity. No or little affinity between DP and DM, between dispersed phase and dispersion medium, there is no affinity or little affinity. Here also, if dispersion medium is water, then in place of lyophobic, we use the word hydrophobic. If the dispersed phase, dispersion medium is water, then we use the word hydrophobic. Which substances form this kind of lyophobic colloids? See, substances with low atomic weight or molecular weight form this type of colloids. Substances with low atomic weight or low molecular weight form this type of colloidal solution. Okay, see some examples for lyophobic colloids. Examples are gold salt. Gold salt, sulfur salt. You know, sulfur salt means sulfur molecules in water. Suspension of this dispersion of sulfur molecules in water is sulfur salt. Similarly, smoke, cloud, etc. These are some examples for lyophobic colloids. So now, have you got an idea about lyophilic and lyophobic? If there is strong affinity between dispersed phase and dispersion medium, that is lyophilic. If there is no affinity or little affinity between dispersed phase and medium, that is called what? Lyophobic. So if a solvent is water, then we use the word hydrophilic in place of lyophilic and hydrophobic in place of lyophobic. Okay, so these are the points, some important points about each kind. Now let's see the differences between these two, lyophilic and lyophobic colloids. Okay, differences between lyophilic and lyophobic salts. So let's see a table. Write one side lyophilic salts one side and the lyophobic salts another side. Lyophilic salts one side, lyophobic salts another side. Let's see the first point in it. You know, lyophilic salts are reversible. That means they can be prepared and they can be separated. Okay, they can be prepared and they can be separated. Whereas lyophobic colloids are irreversible. Their preparation and separation both are difficult. Irreversible. Lyophobic salts are irreversible. That means their separation and preparation both are difficult. These are prepared by direct mixing of DP and DM, dispersed phase and dispersion medium. So by simply agitating the dispersed phase in the medium, we can prepare. See how a starch salt is prepared. Take a starch powder and add to some water, simply warm that solution by stirring. UV starch solid will be prepared. So simply warming starch in water and stirring, starch solid is prepared. Can you prepare gold solid by directly mixing gold in water? Because gold solid is an example for lyophobic. When you drop gold ring in water, does not dissolve. So gold solid can be prepared by direct mixing? Not possible. So it requires a separate method, indirect method for the preparation. So these are not prepared by direct mixing. Not prepared by direct mixing of DP and DM. Third one. In this, DP particles are hydrated. Particles of DP are hydrated. Hydrated means just like a salt. When you dissolve a salt like NaCl, both cation and anion are hydrated. Hydration means surrounding a cation or anion, water molecules in the solvent surround a cation or anion. That type of arresting of either cation or anion or any particle by solvent molecules is called what? Hydration. That occurs, hydration process occurs in the case of lyophilic. You know, because of that, they are very stable colloids. Lyophilic are stable colloids because of extensive hydration. So here, particles of DP, are not hydrated. That is the reason why these are stable, these are unstable. Lyophilic salts are stable, whereas lyophobic are unstable because of this hydration. Here hydration is present, there hydration is absent. Here DP particles, may or may not have charges, dispersed phase particles in lyophilic may have, may not have, whereas in this DP particles have positive or negative charges. If they have positive charges, that is called positive colloid. If DP particles all have positive charge, that is said to be positive colloid. If DP particles have negative charge, that is called negative colloid. So there is a classification like positive and negative colloids. Of course, here also, but all lyophilic colloids may not have charges. Sixth one. So here, in the presence of electrical field, particles may migrate or may not migrate towards electrodes. DP particles may or may not migrate, towards electrodes. DP particles may or may not migrate towards electrodes. But here, DP particles, dispersed phase particles, migrate, towards opposite electrodes. That means, if there are positive charges on the DP particles, they migrate towards cathode. If there are negative charges on the DP particles, they migrate towards anode. We know that cations reach cathode, anions reach anode in the electrolysis process. So here DP particles, if in this colloidal solution, if particles have charges, na they also move towards opposite. If no charge, they do not move in the electrolysis process. Seventh one. Here, coagulation, there is a word. Coagulation means precipitation of a colloidal solution is called coagulation or flocculation. Okay, to coagulate a lyophilic salt, more amount of salt is added. So it is coagulated by more amount of electrolyte. Coagulation means precipitation. Coagulation, precipitation, flocculation, similar words. But we use the word precipitation in a true solution. But coagulation or flocculation, the word is used in colloidal solution. Okay, so a lyophilic salt being stable, for coagulation it needs more amount of salt. But see here, whereas this lyophobic salt coagulated by, it is coagulated by lesser amount of electrolyte. Lesser amount of electrolyte. Why lesser amount is required there? Unstable. Those are unstable. Just by the addition of small amount of salt also, they are coagulated. Here, about coagulation, we have a topic, separate topic in this chapter. There I will discuss why coagulation occurs, what is the mechanism of coagulation. All these points I discuss there. Okay. So the last point, eighth one, you know, there is a special property of a colloidal solution, that is Tyndall effect. What is that? Tyndall effect. So they may show, may not show Tyndall effect. They may or may not show Tyndall effect. They may show or may not show Tyndall effect. Whereas these lyophobic salts, they show Tyndall effect. Tyndall effect means scattering of light by particles of DP. This topic also we have in later topics. There I will discuss what is Tyndall effect. There is a topic we have. So I will discuss there. Simply, Tyndall effect means a scattering of light by particles of DP. So scattering of light occurs in case of lyophobic. But here scattering of light may occur, may not occur. Okay. See, one more point in this, that is ninth property. Here, surface tension, viscosity of a solution. Is more than the DP. Viscosity of a lyophilic salt is more than the viscosity of solution, means total colloidal solution viscosity is more than the viscosity of pure dispersion medium. That means starch salt is more viscous than pure water. Starch salt means starch in water is having more viscosity than pure water. Here, in this case, viscosity of both solution and DM, dispersion medium, are nearly same. These are nearly same. Okay, so these are the differences between lyophilic and lyophobic colloids. Okay, now let's see some examples of colloids, to which type they belong, lyophilic, lyophobic, whether it is emulsion, gel. Let's see some examples. So examples for different types of colloids. Examples of colloids. In that, first one, smoke. See some points about smoke. It is an aerosol in which dispersed phase is carbon particles. Dispersed phase is carbon particles, which is DP, and dispersion medium is air. Dispersion medium is air. So smoke is which type colloid? Solid in gas type colloid. Solid in gas type colloid. So it is solid in gas type aerosol. Next, it is a lyophobic salt. What is that? Lyophobic. Smoke is lyophobic salt. In this dispersed phase is carbon particles, dispersion medium is air. See the second one, cloud. Important for IPE, they may be asked for 2 marks. Mention the dispersed phase and dispersion medium in the following examples. Some examples will be given, which are important words: cloud, milk, smoke, blood, starch salt, gold salt. These are all important. Let's see one by one. Smoke, which type colloid it is? It is an aerosol, that means solid in gas type colloid. Dispersed phase is carbon particles, that means solid. Dispersion medium is air, that means gas. Therefore, it is solid in gas type colloid. Similarly, let's see about cloud. In this, it is also an aerosol in which dispersed phase water droplets, which is liquid. Dispersion medium is air. Air means gas. Okay, so it is also a liquid in gas type colloid. The first one is gas in liquid in solid in gas. The first one, solid in gas. This cloud is liquid in gas type aerosol. It is. Next, it is also a lyophobic colloid. It is also lyophobic colloid. It is also lyophobic. About cloud, it is. Third one, about milk. Milk. You know, milk, it is an emulsion. Later, you will read that emulsions are of two types. solid in liquid, liquid in oil in liquid, liquid in oil in water, water in oil. There are two types of emulsions. One is oil in water, other one is water in oil emulsions. Both are liquids, oil liquid, and water is also liquid. Water in oil type emulsion, oil in water type emulsion. Two types of emulsions are there. Milk belongs to which class? So in this DPEs, dispersed phase is liquid fat. Liquid fat means liquid. Dispersed phase is liquid. Dispersion medium is water, which is also a liquid. So it is oil in water type emulsion. Oil in water type emulsion. Milk is oil in water type emulsion. There is a cod liver oil used in the treatment of asthma. So cod liver oil, it is which type? Water in oil type emulsion. That is, there is a topic there I will discuss. Emulsion, emulsions, there is a separate topic in our chapter. There I will discuss. Okay, so it is oil in water type emulsion, milk is. Next, it is a lyophilic, lyophilic colloid. Milk is a lyophilic because liquid fat more molecular weight, that's why lyophilic. Okay, so we have discussed smoke, cloud, milk. Next, fourth one. Fourth one, blood. In this, blood is which type colloid? It is a sol. Sol means solid in liquid type colloid. Next, in this dispersed phase is albuminoid substances. Albuminoids, that means red blood cells, white blood cells, platelets, some other ingredients, some other components. So dispersed phase, dispersion medium is water containing some ions. Water containing some ions, that is dispersion medium. So here albuminoid substances means solids, water means liquid. That's why blood is a solid in liquid type colloidal solution. Blood is solid in liquid type colloidal solution. Fifth one, starch salt. So blood is simply hydrosol. Okay, what is that? Hydrosol. Hydrosol means dispersion medium is water. Similarly, this starch is also, I forgot a point here. See, in this, is it lyophilic or lyophobic? Yes, it is a lyophilic colloid. It is a lyophilic. Blood is a lyophilic colloid. Next, fifth one, starch salt. Starch salt. What is this? It is also hydrosol. Hydrosol means in which dispersion medium is water. Okay, it is also, but it is having specific name. Of course, here also dispersion medium is water, hydrosol, but it is having a specific name, emulsion, liquid in liquid type colloid, emulsion. That's why here I didn't use the word hydrosol. Here, starch salt is hydrosol, in which dispersed phase is starch, which is a solid. Dispersion medium is water, which is a liquid. So star sol is solid in liquid type colloidal solution. It is also lyophilic. It is lyophilic colloid. Lyophilic colloid it is. Sixth one, gold sol. What is that? Gold sol. In this, it is a hydrosol. That means dispersion medium is water. Dispersal phase is gold particles. Small gold particles, which is a solid. Similarly, dispersion medium is water, which is a liquid. So gold sol is a solid in liquid type colloidal solution. And it is lyophobic. Lyophobic colloid. So these are very important colloids. You may get a very short answer question, that means 2 marks question from any of these 6 colloids: smoke, cloud, milk, blood, starch, gold sol. Okay, so these are different examples for colloids. Now have a look on differences between true solution and colloidal solution. Differences between true solution and colloidal solution. True solution and colloidal solution. So here I want to draw a table with 3 columns. In the first column, property that differentiate both, property. In the second column, true solution. In the third column, colloidal solution. Colloidal solution. First one. Nature of system. You know, true solution is homogeneous system, whereas colloidal solution is heterogeneous system. Homogeneous system means single phasic, whereas colloidal solution is biphasic system, because in colloidal solution there are 2 phases, dispersed phase and a dispersion medium. So that is a biphasic. So if we take a binary solution, that is whether it is binary or ternary, monophasic system. It is monophasic. Okay, but it is biphasic. Biphasic system. Second one, appearance. This true solution, clear solution, appearance is very clear. True solution is very clear solution. You can see the image through a solution, opposite image through the solution. So that means if you see an image opposite to the true solution, very clear that is. So there is no cloudiness. Clear, very clear solution, true solution is. But here, maybe clear or opaque. That means, opaque means not clear. Sometimes some colloidal solutions may be clear, but some colloidal solutions are cloudy. Cloudy means opaque. Third one, separation of solute or dispersed phase by filtration. So here not possible in this true solution, separation of solute and solvent is not possible by filtration. So can you separate sugar and water from sugar solution using filtration? Not possible. If you filter sugar solution, what happens? Nothing will be there on the filter paper. All solution goes through the pores. Similarly, here also not possible. A colloidal solution also not possible to separate DP and DM. Here also not possible. Fourth one. Separation of solute or dispersed phase by ultrafiltration. There is another filtration method. Ultrafiltration. What is the difference between filtration and ultrafiltration? Ultrafiltration. What is the difference? In filter paper, in ordinary filter paper, pores are larger. Whereas in ultrafilter paper, very small sized pores there will be. So even with ultrafilter paper also, separation of solute and solvent is not possible here. But in case of colloidal solution, possible. With ultrafilter paper, it is possible to separate dispersed phase from the dispersion medium. Fifth one, settling of solute or DP particles, settling of solute or DP particles. Here, when you keep sugar solution for some time, sugar particles will not settle down. In a true solution, settling of particles does not occur. Even in a colloidal solution also, settling does not occur. Even though there is settling of colloidal solution occurs when some salt is added to it, because there occurs a growth in size of colloidal particles. Because of growth in size, particles aggregate and they settle down. That is a different matter. So without addition of any substance, if a colloidal solution is kept aside, now they will not settle down. But by centrifugation, colloidal particles may settle down. So settling of solute particles in a true solution not possible. But in a colloidal solution, possible by centrifugation. Possible by centrifugation. Next property. There is a property, Tyndall effect. Previously, we have discussed about that. That Tyndall effect is not shown by true solutions do not show Tyndall effect. Tyndall effect means scattering of light. Because in this solute particle is very small sized particle, very small sized. That's why Tyndall effect is not possible in true solutions. You know, colloidal solution, they may show, they may not show. May not show. Previously, we have discussed that lyophobic may show, may not show. Lyophilic may show or may not show colloidal dispersal. What is that? Tyndall effect. But lyophobic, all lyophobic salts, they show Tyndall effect. So, may or may not show. Which one? Colloidal solutions. Seventh one, important part, property, size of solute or DP particles. Size of solute or dispersed phase. In these true solutions, size of solute is lesser than or equal to 10 power minus 9 meters. That means one nanometer. Whereas size of DP particles in these colloidal solutions are in the range from minus 9 meters to 10 power minus 6 meters. That is the size range. Okay, this is the table which shows the differences between true solutions and colloidal solutions.